جنات أندروبيا.
Welcome to Everest Physics Academy.
In this video, we are going to write the expression of the position vector in a plane. Write the characteristics of the position vector. Relate the magnitude of the position vector to the distance from the origin of coordinates. Solve an exercise about the position vector.
A plane motion is a motion in two dimensions. Imagine a cannonball being fired at some angle from the horizontal. The ball is moving in two dimensions. The Cartesian coordinate system is suitable to describe the two-dimensional motion. We will use only the x and y axes with unit vectors I and j.
Now, let's move to the position vector. Usually, we use the Cartesian coordinate system to determine the position of an object. The position vector is a vector adjoining the origin of the Cartesian system and the position of the object. This vector is given by xi plus yj. X and y are called the parametric equations. They are changing with time. To understand the position vector, observe this animation. A ball is thrown in air, and we draw the position vector at each position. At this position, x is equal to 15.86 meters, and y is equal to 6.38 meters, or the coordinates of the ball are 15.86 meters and 6.38 meters. As you see, x and y are changing with time, and now x becomes 26.24 meters and y becomes -7.93 meters.
Let's move to the characteristics of the position vector, or look at the figure. A particle moves on a curved path. We draw the position vector of m at a certain instant. Let's move to the origin of r. All position vectors start from the origin O of coordinates. Let's move to the line of action. The line of action is the line joining O and the position of the particle at this instant. The direction is always from O towards m. Now, look at the expression of the position vector. It is xi plus yj. Therefore, the magnitude of r is equal to the square root of x squared plus y squared. Consider again the figure. The magnitude om of the position vector represents the distance separating m from O at this instant.
Focus, please. This is important.
Now, let's solve an application about the position vector. The position vector of a moving particle m is given by t minus 2i plus 2t squared j in si. Before solving the questions, let's observe an animation about the motion of the particle m. Number 1. Write the parametric equations of the motion of m. As you know, r equal xi plus yj. So, by comparing, x equal t minus 2 and y equal 2t squared. Number 2. Write the expression of the position vector at time 0 and at time 3 seconds. To write the expression of r of 0, substitute t equals 0 in the expression of r. So, r of 0 equal 0 minus 2 times I plus 2 times 0 times j. Therefore, r of 0 equal minus 2i in meters. Similarly, r of 3, substitute t equal 3 in the expression of r, then r of 3 equal I plus 18j in meters.
Let's move to part 3. Determine the expression of the distance d separating m from the origin O of coordinates as a function of time, and then calculate the distance at time 1 second. In a previous slide, we have seen that the magnitude of the position vector at a certain instant is equal to the distance separating the particle from O at this instant, and it is equal to the square root of x squared plus y squared. Then replace x by t minus 2 and replace y by 2t squared. So we get this expression. This is going to be d is equal to the square root of t squared plus 4 minus 4t plus 4t power 4. Now this is the expression of the distance at any instant. Now we want to calculate this distance at time 1 second. So we will replace t in this expression by 1 second. Therefore, the distance separating M from O at time 1 second is equal to 2.2 meters.
Part 4. Prove that M passes by the point whose coordinates are minus 1 meter and 2 meters. To prove that M passes by this point, we have to prove that at the same instant, X equal minus 1 and Y equal 2 meters. We know that X equal T minus 2. When x equal minus 1, t equal 1 second. So let's calculate the value of y of 1. Replace t by 1 in the expression of y, then y of 1 equal 2 times 1 squared, which is equal to 2 meters. So therefore, m passes through the point of coordinates minus 1 meter and 2 meters. 5. Determine the instant at which m meets the y-axis. We know that when m meets the y-axis, x is equal to 0. So replace x equal 0, then 0 equal t minus 2, therefore t equal 2 seconds. So m meets the y-axis at t equal 2 seconds.
Let's move to part 6. Draw the vectors r0 and r at time 3 seconds in the xy plane. In a previous slide, we have the expression of r0. It is minus 2i, which means that x is equal to minus 2 meters and y is equal to 0. So we are here, abscissa. The abscissa is minus 2 and the ordinate is 0. Remember, to draw the position vector, it starts from the origin O of coordinates and directed towards the position of the particle at this instant. So this is r0. Let's move to r at time 3 seconds. It is equal to I plus 18j. So the abscissa is 1 and the ordinate is 18 meters. So we are here. Now, to draw the position vector at time 3 seconds, it starts from O and directed towards the position of M at time 3 seconds.
Thank you for watching. If you like this video,
subscribe to the channel, hit the like button, and share.